So this topic will cover first introduction and then sustainability and heritage. Then I will talk about critical assessment of GBC historic building certification, integration of BIM, demonstration of the case study and conclusions. So first of all, the purpose of my dissertation was to explore feasibility of implementing BIM in environmentally sustainable historic building restoration and to implement HBIM in the process for GBC historic building certification. The objectives were to develop a BIM framework for creating the certification deliverable called Historic Building Identity Card and to enable the framework to be extendable on the complete certification project. The methodology used was to identify the current practice of HBIM and the needs of the certification, to develop the holistic BIM workflows, and then to gather data requests for the historic building identity card, to develop BIM framework, to implement it, demonstrate the results, and gather the conclusions. So regarding the sustainability in a heritage, one of the ways of achieving environmentally sustainable development is obtaining certification for the buildings according to standardized rating systems. Rating system represented here is a LEED certification system. The assessment is structured according to the building types and divided into thematic areas by key aspects of the building. Each thematic area represents a credit category which contains a certain number of specific topics called credit. Credit categories shown here are for the LEED version 4, and there are 7 categories in this case. And this dissertation further focused on a GBC historic building, that is a certification system that measures the sustainability of building according to thematic areas of the LEED rating system, adding a new category called historic value. It is made to preserve the cultural value of the built environment, favoring the enhancement of its environmental sustainability. And the dissertation focuses on the newly introduced historic value credit category. The identified needs for the management of environmentally sustainable heritage renovations were to develop standards for geometric and non-geometric information, and to develop a framework that enables interoperability and traceability between multiple stakeholders and phases. So the next step was to critically assess the GBC certification. It had been done by analyzing the GBC historic building manual, examining credits in the context of BIM implementation by collecting data and translating it into BIM. So first of all, it had been noticed that the information requested for different credits can overlap, be closely related and have mutual influence. A graphical representation of connections between each credit is presented here. From the diagram, it is possible to have an overview and estimate the connection between credits in general and decide on the approach for their application. The credits are represented with circles grouped by their belonging category with colors and positions. If the credits are observed chronologically, the first category in the design process is a historic value. It is the core of the decision-making process for the subsequent phases. And then, in order to map the information requests from the GBC manual to BIM information types, the requests have been analyzed by each credit using spreadsheet to extract the key information, categorizing it according to various criteria. And each criteria is represented by a column, and columns are grouped by the topic analyzed. The example here given is for the prerequisite one of the historic value. And afterwards, personal comments and opinion of BIM applicability for each credit was given. The scale is designed from 1 to 5, with 1 being non-applicable and 5 grading BIM as a tool that is used for the step of the data sorting. This is the sample of the historic building identity card. It is a document in PDF format that contains a basic knowledge of the building, and the information requested for this deliverable consists of 3 aspects. That is project information, technological units information, and graphical documentation as attachments. After the systematic analysis, BIM workflows for the credits of the historic value were proposed. This is the proposed workflow for the preliminary analysis, prerequisite 1. So according to the BIM execution plan, the on and off-site analysis results should be inserted in a common data environment, and a 3D model can be made by using a pre-made template. Information should be updated accordingly, and when it's finished, the ID card of the historic building can be exported, and after the final revision by BIM manager, the documentation can be published. Next phase was proposing framework and implementing it. So conceptually represented, the three topics that are requiring non-graphical and graphical data contain information that can be translated to BIM contents. BIM properties are non-graphical data that are used to provide information for each of the three topics. Classes of object, and material libraries are BIM contents that are used to create document building elements and therefore the technological units information. And in the end, the drawing templates are the rules for creating drawing documentation and using BIM for keeping graphical data consistent. This is the process map of framework creation. So first, the information is mapped to BIM information types using a standard IFC or creating the custom properties. Names, data types, locations, and groupings are defined. Then the Excel template was prepared in order to transfer the properties to authoring tool. Then the method for data transfer to authoring tool is prepared. And finally, the template is created in authoring tool, defining object classification, drawing template, and exporting setup. After the template is created, its application by the design team can be performed. It includes filling the Excel templates, inserting the data in the authoring tool, and extending the predefined libraries according to project needs. Lastly, the information is exported for the further phases and the ID card can be filled. Here is the display, a sample of the implemented framework, actually of the first step. So the requests are mapped and sorted in the spreadsheet template. It can be done for all of the three topic categories, so project information, technological units, and graphic documentation. The next step is to implement the data method for the data transfer. It had been done by using Dynamo. The Dynamo setup graphs are designed to be used only to set up new project template files, so the team can later only use Dynamo Player in order to input the variable information. They are to choose the scripts to run and the inputs for the Excel file location, its sheet name, Revit element categories to apply the properties to. Then they can run the player and get the Dynamo to insert the compiled data from Excel. Autodesk Revit was used as an authoring tool to implement object classification, property management, project browser organization, and the drawing template. Regarding object classification, the keynoting element and material library, as well as shared material library were created. Each element is assigned with a unique code, and the keynoting library was created in order to document the material applied to any element and demonstrate its code via text. The material library was created to form the graphical representation of material itself, as well as to enable user to insert the non-graphical information on the materials. It would serve to the design team as a shareable database, which can be supplemented when necessary. Next, an adaptive component family was created to represent stone degradation types. The reference used was ICOMOS Illustrated Glossary on Stone Deterioration Patterns. Each family type represents a damage type with circular geometric form and specific color that can be attached to a Revit element and resized according to damage size. Additional information can be supplemented with property values. Then the exporting setup was defined using custom property mapping file in order to fully control the parameter export to IFC. And the results of the framework would be Excel and Revit templates that can be adapted by BIM managers. Next, framework is demonstrated on the case study. It was a section of a ducal palace in Chimaraes. So the Excel spreadsheets were filled, inserted in the Revit. This is the example of the project browser organization of views and sheets that are organizing the whole documentation set. Using the same spreadsheet, the preset sheet list schedule in Revit was filled, creating an overall checklist of the certification. The team can use it as a control of the project, assessing the status of each sheet at any time. Custom existing properties are inserted and filled too. This is the example for the project information and properties for wall element categories. And the preset schedules with informations are then filled automatically and can be exported, of course, to Excel spreadsheets. The graphical documentation was achieved using drawing templates. Filters and color schemes were mainly used to represent the requested drawings. Each color represents either a function or phase of the element's constructions. And these are also the examples for demonstrating shell materials, their keynotes, and the degradation forms. And after that, the model was exported to IFC. This is the model with defined properties within the property set for the project information and wall categories. And lastly, the PDF form was filled using exported spreadsheets. Here are samples of the field project information and technological units information. So to conclude, in general, it was possible to apply holistic BIM approach on the certification. The data systematization in Revit template was achieved, and also the combination of IFC and the custom-made properties. It was possible to export the different data types systematically and to make the framework extendable on the further credits. And for the future, it is recommended to expand this principle to the rest of the certification, to use computational tools for calculations and control checks, to implement modeling rules for each phase, to standardize historic elements and properties information, to establish an open platform as a comprehensive database, and to develop repository methodologies. Thank you.